I am prepared, and we will start off in the AFC North. We're going to fire in with my Pittsburgh Steelers. Now, I've been a fan of the Steelers my entire life. I didn't really have much of an option. You know, when I was really, really little, my dad has always been a fan of the Steelers. His dad was always a fan of the Steelers for whatever reason. We are not from that part of the country. I think it had to do with, you know, the way that they played back in the 60s, 70s, whatever. But they don't play like that now, really. So there's a lot that needs to be fixed with the Pittsburgh Steelers. Their needs, they went 12-4 last year. They won the division. They were a little fraudulent. Schedule helped out a little bit. But went 12-4, went 1-4 down the stretch, and then got blown out in the playoff game at home against the Brownies, which was just a complete abomination. But we won't talk about that too much. Their needs are they need a center, they need a tight end, they need cornerback, they need running back, they need edge help.
And they need a quarterback.
Yeah, really, really.
And they need a quarterback, yeah. I mean, Dwayne Haskins isn't the future? I don't understand. I'm very confused.
I hope to God Dwayne Haskins is the future.
So here's what they ended up doing. In round one, they got running back Najee Harris out of Alabama. Round two, tight end Pat Freiermuth out of Penn State. Round three, they got a center, Kendrick Green, out of Illinois. So far, first three picks, okay. Like, I think there were more things that you could have done rather than take a running back in the first round. Obviously, if you followed this show for any amount of time, you know that we are not fans of taking running backs in the first round, especially when you need a lot of offensive line help. Pat Freiermuth, that's okay. That's a decent value pick. Kendrick Green, the center out of Illinois, super athletic. I think this was a really, really good pick. Offensive tackle Dan Moore Jr. out of Texas A&M in the fourth round. Linebacker Buddy Johnson out of Texas A&M in the fourth round as well, just about 12 picks later. Then you get into round five, and you've got defensive interior lineman Isaiah Loudermilk out of Wisconsin, edge rusher Quincy Roche out of Miami, Florida, safety Trey Norwood out of Oklahoma in the seventh round, and punter Presley Harvin III out of Georgia Tech. I love the punter pick because Presley Harvin was awesome to watch. Like, he can hit bombs. Yeah. So I like, you know, I'm not a huge fan of this draft. I don't think that they really hit on all of the things that they needed. But, you know, the players that they got, I think are going to be okay. I don't know how what they did really fixes their issues right now. Kyle, jump in and tell me your thoughts here.
Yeah, so I'm with you. I like the players. Look, Najee Harris, he looks like Derrick Henry Jr. He's an absolute beast. And there's no doubt Pittsburgh needs help in their running game. The problem with the running game last year, though, even though James Conner is about as explosive as a snail, and they needed to move on from him, and there was nothing useful about having him in the backfield whatsoever. I know he's a great story and all that, but he was just sluggish. And trust me, he's been a keeper because I got drafted him really late during the Le'Veon Bell year, so I'm still getting him in my keeper league in like the ninth round, and I just hate that James Conner is on my team. So it's an upgrade. But the problem was not the running backs. The problem was their offensive line was probably the worst in football. That's why, look, everyone bagged on this offense. Oh, they're doing these 2.5 second passes, these quick passes. That's because they had to. They didn't have a choice. Ben had no time to drop back. So really, even though I like the players, to me, their biggest need by far and away wasn't even close was that offensive line. They should have been doing nothing but drafting and trading and drafting and trading for offensive linemen before. I mean, they still have Benny Snell, who they just took, in the second, third round last year.
Yeah.
So going and taking the running back, even though I love the player, I think he's a fantastic player. I love watching him play, and he's certainly going to help. Like, he'll be able to break some tackles when that line's not making any holes, and he'll be able to make something happen. But for me, they just didn't really address the needs they really needed to address. So I'm not a huge fan of this draft, although I do love a few of the players. And I love it when punters are drafted, always. Punters and kickers drafted always makes me happy. I don't know why. It just makes me laugh, and it's just kind of goofy. But, they sort of missed the mark for me. Offensive line would have been where I headed if I was running this team. Do love Najee Harris, though. I really do like the player.
Yeah, I'm the same here. I love Najee as well. He's the only Alabama player I've liked in the last decade. But I think he's going to be fun. The problem is how fun is he going to be until they can fix this line? That's not their problem. If they had a mobile running quarterback that could help keep the defense a little bit honest.
Or move the pocket or anything. Yeah.
But you're talking about you've got an absolute statue and a terrible offensive line. Those are the two worst things you can give a good explosive running back right there. That doesn't help them at all. Any threat of a run would be better than nothing. And they just don't have it. And so I just didn't understand. I just don't get it. You look at Jacksonville, who's not a very good football team, and they take a nobody and turn him into a 1,000-yard rusher. I don't get why you're using this kind of capital on running backs. It doesn't make sense. I don't like their draft. I don't think they did well. I think this team, which has done unbelievable, they're probably one of the most stable franchises in all the NFL. Listen, at some point in time, the foundation cracks and it all starts falling apart. And I think the Steelers are looking at DFL in this division right now going into this year. I really do. I know Tomlin's finished less with a losing record. Well, guess what? He's got an extra game that he gets to lose at the end of the season now, okay? And that schedule's not going to work out as easy as it did last year.
So. You're 100% right about that. They did get a lot of value on Quincy Roche out of Miami. Trey Norwood, I love him as a player. Isaiah Loudermilk out of Wisconsin. Chris, you and I have watched him multiple times. Only two picks were offensive linemen. You know, Kendrick Green, you know, listed as a center. He can play guard as well. Like, you can move him around some. I just, out of all of these picks that they took, only two offensive linemen. And that's where it really gets to.
There's no value that you're getting in the fifth and sixth round. The value in the fifth and sixth round are all just bites at the apple. That is literally just slinging spaghetti up against the wall and hoping it sticks.
I will guarantee you.
That's not value.
I will guarantee you that Quincy Roche will play. Like, I will guarantee
Would he play in Cleveland? Would he play in Dallas? Would he play in Minnesota? Like, these aren't like unbelievable franchises here, but these are good teams, not terrible teams. He's going to play there because the people in front of him are dog shit.
Yeah. Okay.
That doesn't mean he's good.
Yeah. That's a valid point. Like, I think he'll be able to play behind T.J. Watt and Alex Highsmith and those guys. You know, Bud Dupree being gone, like, that's obviously it's something that you got to figure out. Trey Norwood is going to come in and shore up, hopefully, that safety spot. But these are seventh-round guys. Like, you know, sixth, seventh-round. Who knows? Like,
if you're counting on sixth and seventh-round guys starting for your team, you've got major issues.
I think it's more bigger problems.
Exactly. Yeah,
it's a bit of an issue. It's definitely a bit of an issue. So I like the guys. Don't like the draft. I'll say that much. Let's move on. We're going to go. Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com, and if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter at GaryWCE, at ChrisBGiannini, at WinningCures, or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com, or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.